Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum friends. You are watching CSE Guide. Today I will tell you about CSE scholarship for 2020. Means upcoming scholarships and the scholarship for next year. How you apply for scholarships, how you make documents, how to fill CSE form, etc. How to find a professor, how you send email to professors. All this complete information included in this video. So if you watch the complete video, so you don't need any agent, or you don't hire any agent. So if you watch the video carefully, then you think that it's very useful for you. So first I will tell you that how to send emails. The first process is that the first process of CSE scholarship is acceptance letter. Means you need an acceptance letter from professor in which university you want to apply. So I also give you the list of those universities who offer scholarship. I think 250 plus universities which are offering scholarship. So first, the basic step of this scholarship is acceptance letter. Means acceptance letter means that in university in which you want to apply, a professor you need a professor which supervision you. So that's why you need an acceptance letter. It's not compulsory, but it increases the chances of your admission or getting scholarship. So in acceptance letter, two things keep in mind. First, how to find a professor, and other is how to send email to professor. Means listening the name of acceptance letter, you must comes in mind how you get the acceptance letter. So first, to find a professor, how to find a professor and how to contact with the professor to get an acceptance letter. And after finding professor, another question comes in your mind is that how to send emails and which email you send to the professor that you got the acceptance letter. So I will tell you the complete process for acceptance letter. So first process is the acceptance letter. So okay, you don't worry about that. Everything is easy. So if you think that you are applying for the scholarship for 2020, then you must follow this video. So first we tell you how to find a professor. So first we type here Harbin Institute of Technology. Means this is the university, one of the universities in which offer scholarship. This university is one of those universities which have deadlines early December. Late December means first university and first deadline of this university. So Harbin Institute of Technology, the deadline of this university is 13th of December. Means every 13th December is the last date of the scholarship. This is the only university whose first admission. So first is the Harbin Institute of Technology. So type here which university you want to find a professor. Type the name of the university here and click on search, and then click on hit first option. Okay, and after clicking on first option, then you don't find the professor when you are typing university name and English in en.hit.edu. Means this, when you open this link is in English, and in English link sometimes you cannot find the professor emails and not find the faculty of all the department in this university. So I will also give the solution of this. Okay, typing first, we check that either we find the professor in this university, then click on hit option. Means maybe we find professor in English link, in English link. Okay, after clicking on that, you will find that that type of option. Then click on academic research and faculty. Every university have not same theme like that. Sometimes you find academic and research, sometimes you find institutes, faculty and etc. That's types of options. So I will also make another video for how to find a profession. I will make complete video on this, because I also tell in this video in 2 to 5 minutes. So it's very useful for you, but for those students who don't listen and who don't understand to find a professor, then I will make a proper video and complete video again on this scholar, on this option. I will on this method I will make on this. So click on academics, okay. Then click on academic and then click on faculty. Okay, after clicking on faculty, then you will find that's all the departments, all these departments in which you select your departments in you want to apply and click on that. So my major is civil engineering, so I click on civil engineering. So you know you are watching that when I come to the cursor on this civil engineering option, then this is not giving any options. You cannot open it. Okay, the solution is that this the linking in the option en.it.eu, that's why this is not open, because the Chinese link cannot open in English. So the solution is that back to the Google click on website option. When you click on website option, then this link open in Chinese and you will find the professor easily. Okay, when after clicking or use the main purpose is to find professor, must use Google Chrome, not use Firefox and Safari, etc., all these types of browsers. Only use Google Chrome, because this is automatically translate the Chinese page into English. So after clicking on website, then that type of home page is open. Click on try again, because net is so a little bit slow. So after clicking on that, when this is translated, then you will find that's been translated. So then click on school and department or department name like this, because this is the translated, so page is not properly translated. So click on department. After clicking on department, then you will find, you see that the faculty list of these scholarship means this is the colleges. These are the colleges. This is only for this university that this is shown like the chart. So flow chart. This is not happens in all the universities. Okay. Then click on option one by one. Then you will find that your own school and your own department. Okay. Click on that option. Okay, then you will find on the main bar you should see that which is the department. This is translated, and you think that you saw that school of astronomers Harbin Institute means if your school is my school is not in astronomy, my school is civil engineering. So I click on another next option. These are all the schools, but in Chinese, so don't worry about that. This is school in, I think, power. This is for electrical, I think. So if your school is not in power, in engineering, etc., so come back. Okay, we will come back and click on next option. So these are all the schools in which you want to apply. This is a school of electrical engineering and automation. So one by one you can click on that and find your own department. So now I come to the China University of Mining and Technology. We find another come to another university and find the professor or for other universities. So after clicking, after writing China University of Mining Technology, then you don't find, and so when you're not finding the options website there, then you will then I will give you the other solution. So after typing here, you must raise the option. Yeah, raise the English ENG dot raise the option and write the www.cumt.edu.cn website. Then you, after doing this, your application, your website page open in Chinese, and then you will translate it into English. Okay, automatically translated. After translating, then translate the page, then you click on school profile or education. That's you are seeing that. But our main purpose is to find faculty, and you must find the option institutional setting. Institutional setting is one of the most useful option for you when you find a professor. Click on institutional settings and go to the college settings. Institutional settings in the option. The third one option is that college setting. After clicking on college section, you will find your school in which you want to apply an event in which you want to find a professor. So after clicking on that, this will the link which has been opened. So don't worry, this is very easy for you. So when your this group is trans this page in translating, you see seeing that all these majors are here. So my major is civil engineering. I applied civil engineering. All these majors are available. You can click on that option and you find your faculty of your major department. So I click on civil. So my civil engineering group link has been opened. So okay. No, you have then find your option after opening after opening your school means my major is civil. So after opening your school profile school website, then click on faculty option. Okay. After clicking on faculty option, then you see that teachers, colleges, academic parts, etc. Teacher profile. Okay. Now click on teachers. After clicking on teachers, we will find that all these are the professors. When you click on one professor, then you will go to their profile. Okay, when you click that, and the page has been opened, and this is the profile of one teacher. And copy this email and send to professor email. And how which email you send to professor, I will tell in the video. Next, in this video, in too late, in later. So first the process is to inform you and is to understand you that you how to find an email of professor. So one by one. You send to the emails one by one to all the professors. All send emails, all emails to professor, all professors, and it's increase your chance to get the acceptance letter. So send only send emails to professors or associate professors. Not send emails to lecturers and assistants, etc. So only professor and associate professor emails. So first how to find a professor is has been complete. So now we came forward to how we send email to professor. Okay, how we send email to professor. Open your Gmail and write in the compose option. Okay, after compose option you will write your mail here. Okay now means in the email in which you want to send the professor write your email, professor email here. Okay, so I write their demo email gsdf@gmail.com. okay, and in the subject you write there this request for supervision. You must write two options: request for supervision or request of acceptance letter for supervision. There's two things you write here. Request for supervision is a good option for you, and request of acceptance letter for supervision is also two options you which you are write in the in this subject line. So after reading that, respected professor, I am Mohammed from Laflam. This is profile of a one student. So okay, this is one student, civil engineering, and this is the email which you want to which you send to the professor. And also make a strong CV in which your professional and educational background is research background you mentioned in the CV. So also attach the CV with this email. So after watching your CV, then professor decide to give you acceptance letter. So I make a WhatsApp group for this guidance, and that is link in the description. You join our WhatsApp group. I will provide the email format. This the email format you are seeing is I provide this email format on this group. So must join this our WeChat group. WhatsApp group. I will give you the WeChat. I will give my WeChat ID on this WhatsApp group, and you will join our WeChat group also. WeChat group is for those students. Means if you are really interested to go to China, then you must join our WeChat group. WeChat group is WeChat is only working in China. Means which mostly work in China. In China, no Facebook, no YouTube. So they use only WeChat. Okay, I also give these email pattern in my WhatsApp group. So join our WhatsApp groups and give your give this email pattern. Okay. Okay. Now we will go to now. Now we find that how to find admission. What is the find that what is the admission deadline and how to check that how to check that which university in which you want to apply, what is the deadline, what required documents for this university. Every university has specific documents, means some documents are common for every university. Every university, but a little bit one or two documents has been changed for every university. So after we check that, what is the admission and how to check that admission deadline. Click on means we check that Harbin University of Technology, then click on after clicking then click on admissions. Okay, after clicking on admission you will find that this is the link and this is the option which you saw that. Okay, then click on Chinese Government Scholarship. Okay, click on Chinese Government Scholarship, you will see that all the details, all these details are available. Means this is the previous I will saw the option in the previous year, means 2019 to 2020. This is not for 2020 and 2021. Okay, this is the application duration is to 31st of December. I will tell you in earlier. So this is the deadline of this university and what is the eligibility criteria. Eligibility criteria is all of those who are eligible if you have master degree. Okay, master program, they are offering 3000 RMB per month for masters and 2000 to 3500 RMB for PhD candidate. Okay, these are showing that. Oh, okay, this is the application material. All the application material in duplicate, means the applicants need to provide following materials. Means all these documents which are showing down, so these are two copies of each documents. Okay, first is the application form of Chinese Government Scholarship. Means the application form of Chinese Government Scholarships, you will download this this from the website given in the this is the website given. Okay, you will fill that form on this link. This is the link. Open this link and fill the form and download the form. When you are filling this, when you submit the form, how to submit the form, I will also tell in this video. Okay, after filling the form, download it. When you submit the form, submit the online form, it will be downloaded. When you download it and print out the application form and attach with all these required documents. Okay, that is the second one. Those which are okay. Okay, highest full-time study diploma means this means that your highest degree which you are previous degree which you recently passed out from your university. So notarized copy means original notarized documents, English or Chinese. This is not means that original degree which you got from your university. Okay, this is original notarized means copy of your latest degree, copy of your latest degree, and go to your courts nearest court in your city. So when you go there and say them, I notarize my documents, they will notarize mean stamp on your documents, and you will take a charge for 10 to 15 rupees per documents. So if you not student who not have any not received any means you not receive your highest diploma, your highest degree which you are recently passed, you have transcript but you not have degree. So you do not have degree, so make provisional from you provisional certificate from your authentic provisional certificate from your university and attach notarize it. And the students who are studying in 7th or 8th semester, you make your hope certificate from your university and attach with it. So transcripts also notarized, you have must have notarized transcripts. Okay, study plan or research plan. I will also make a video how to make a research plan and how to make recommendation letter. Okay, the research study plan, I will also make a video on this after after this video, after uploading this video, I will make next video on this, on this how to prepare documents, document step one, step by step. Okay, the study plan is 1800 words. Okay, though this is the the link which you are showing, that open this link and find the format of this university. Find the format of this university for research plan. But this is only for this university and for some 5 to 4 universities, I think. This is those universities have own study plan, but for mostly universities have some common research study plan. So I will also make a video on this. Okay, two recommendation letters by professors or professor. Okay, two recommendation letter means the university in which you passed your degree, go to your professors and says them, please give me a recommendation letter. I want to apply for Chinese government scholarship. They will make the recommendation letter I give to you. So if you your university not having any professor, associate professor, then make me to says them you are the professor. Just make recommendation letter and a passport, a valid passport copy. You must have passport copy. If you don't have any passport, then make your passport as soon as possible, because without passport you don't apply for this scholarship. For physical photocopy or physical foreign examination form, I will what is the physical examination form? I will make a video on this. What is that? How to fill that and sector? I think I also included in this video. So must watch this video complete. You will all covering all the bank receipt means some universities have a registration fee. Means this like this university, 400 RMB registration fee. It will equal to I think 18,000 Pakistani rupees and $60. Means you are what is the dollar rate of your country, in your country. So, but mostly universities have not having reservation free fees. They just send documents to them. They do not pay any fee. Okay. No, these are all 9th and 10th point is all the documents which you send to the university, and this is the account number in which you pay the fee from your own country. Go to bank and say them this is the account number and SWIFT code is for the university in which I want to pay my fee. Okay, acceptance letter not a must. Means if you have acceptance letter, then attach with acceptance letter with your documents. English proficiency certificate. Okay, this is the main option. The next option is English proficiency certificate. Okay, English proficiency certificate. If you go to your university in which you have passed your previous degree and says them please give me English proficiency certificate, they will give you the English proficiency certificate. This is not easy. Okay, the final result come out in July every year. So if you are interested, then apply and prepare your documents and in which address you send your documents. This is the admission for every university where write that international student office or contact us. So you copy this and fill write this address on your parcel and send it to them. Okay, so don't worry about that. Okay, this is the send email to professor, sometime professor says that please send me acceptance letter format, then this is the acceptance letter format, download it. This is not saying all the professor not saying, but sometimes professor says that then download this acceptance letter format and send to professor, send to them. If you join our WeChat or WhatsApp group, then you don't feel any problem regarding scholarship acceptance letter, physical examination form, study plan, etc. We will give you complete information just free of cost, no fee. We are providing information just free. Sometimes people says that join our group and ask to you that please pay the fee. I will give you the admission and all these things, other things. Okay, now this is the format of all these things. Okay. Now I will tell you that the basic and common documents which you send to every university, and every university required common documents. So this is the first is the acceptance letter. Okay, First is the acceptance letter. For acceptance letter, how to find a professor? You see the email. You see the video first, and we send emails. Which email sent to professor? I also describe in my video. And the second documents is the required documents is that highest degree. Highest degree means the previous degree, recently degree you passed out. Means if you want to apply for PhD, then you must have MPhil, Master, or MS degree. So if you want to apply for Master, then you must have a Bachelor degree. If you don't have Bachelor degree, then make provisional certificate from your university. And if you are student of 7th or 8th semester, then make hope certificate from your university. Okay. The second is a transcript. You must have transcript. If you are in 7th or 8th semester, then you make your result card, I think, means 7th semester detailed. Okay, third is the passport, and fourth one is the physical examination form. How to fill the physical examination form, where to get the physical examination form, I tell you in my next video. Okay, and how to make your professional CV, I think I inform from my side. How to make your professional CV in which attractive CV. If the professor watch your CV and give you acceptance letter, I will make next video. And the other one thing is study plan. How to make study plan, I will give the idea. If you join our WhatsApp group, then we will describe the about study plan there. Two recommendation letter from your university, from previous university, English proficiency certificate also from previous university, and other documents. Other documents means when you are attaching documents, then other documents, in other documents, acceptance letter, you are any other language courses. Means if you are if you have Chinese courses, Chinese courses, and HSK means HSK. If you have HSK means the Chinese language courses, then also attach this. And if you have police clearance certificate, then must upload police clearance certificate and other certificates which you think that this increase my chances. Okay. Fee slip means some universities have fee slips. They says to you that upload your fee slip or send fee slip with other documents. This is the basic required documents. Okay.